In today's video, we are seeing what happens when molten metal meets crayons. Guys, before we begin, I really want to address the elephant in the room. What are we melting?
Crayons.
Are you sure they're not crayons?
I pronounce them crayons. It's a two-syllable word. It starts with cray, ends with on.
What elementary student says crayon? It's crayon. It's a crayon. We're melting crayons.
It's got too many letters to be one syllable. It's crayon.
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 A few moments later.
Either way, we're gonna do some fun things with molten metal. Wax melts at a very low temperature, aluminum melts at a much higher temperature, and we just wanna see what happens when they combine. One interesting question is whether or not the color from the crayons can actually do something to alter the color of the metal. What do you think?
You know, I'm gonna go with no. You can't actually color metal. In fact, if you see colored metal, it's plated, I believe.
Or painted,
yes.
Or anodized. I don't think that there's a way to actually add color to metal, but crayons do have a lot of color in them, so maybe something will rub off.
Crayons themselves are made of paraffin wax and pigment. Now, paraffin wax, believe it or not, has a flash point. It actually can be set on fire. So, do you think that these are actually going to melt, or are they just gonna light on fire?
I bet both. I think it's going to melt, followed very quickly by lighting on fire.
Both?
Both.
Both is good.
Both. Both. Both is good.
Here's the basic idea. We're gonna melt down a bunch of aluminum and then add some crayons. What's gonna happen? Will it melt the crayons? Will it light them on fire? Will the crayons actually stain the color of the metal?
All right, Nate, we have got our foundry. We have got...
many crayons.
Many. We got many crayons.
Let's melt some aluminum.
I like it. So, the aluminum that we're melting isn't actually our normal wire that we have. Nate, what did you put in there?
It's half a roll of aluminum foil.
It's aluminum foil.
It's a big, heavy roll of aluminum foil. It's actually a pretty easy source of aluminum to get. This is, I'm sure, some alloy. I don't imagine this is perfectly pure elemental aluminum, but it's very close. And so we're gonna use it. It's cheap, it's easy, and you can get it at the grocery store. Crayons are made almost entirely of wax with a little bit of pigment inside and then, of course, paper wrapped around them. What we're testing out is the viability of using crayons as candles in perhaps an emergency situation. I'm also curious to see if the different colors burn at different rates, different speeds. It already looks like our black wax candle slash crayon is burning a little bit more intensely than the others, but we're gonna see how long they last as well. I saw one supposed life hack online that talked about how a crayon will burn forward and then it had a specific amount of time, but it said it as though it was always gonna be exactly that amount of time, so I'm curious if different candles burn for different rates. But we'll see how they all do. Maybe it's true, maybe it's not. The idea is that the paper is going to act as sort of a wick for the molten wax, kind of like an inside-out candle. The wick is on the outside rather than on the inside. Are they all gonna keep going? We're gonna have to test and find out. We already had two kind of fail, and I'm not sure exactly what happened. I was able to relight them, but the green and the yellow, which are the ones that went out, are now they're going out again.
We're gonna drop one crayon into our molten aluminum, see what happens. Beautiful.
It's on fire. It's on fire.
Wow.
I think immediately the paper probably lit on fire.
So that is paraffin wax. So do you think that the wax itself melted and is now just sitting on the surface? Because it's not as dense as the aluminum.
That's true.
But it does catch fire.
We can sort of see part of it now.
I think that's paper.
I think so. I think the paper survived for the most part.
Yes!
Melting and on fire. You can see the little puddle of wax. You're lighting your camera on fire there.
Oh, that's really cool.
And it's, now you can just see it sort of dancing on the surface of the aluminum.
That's exactly what I said. I didn't think it was actually going to sink
in.
I thought it would melt on the top and light on fire.
With normal candles, the heat from the wick is actually vaporizing a little bit of the wax, and then it's that vapor.
The wax is the fuel.
Yeah, it's that vapor that actually ignites. The liquid wax and the solid wax aren't burning, but the vaporized wax is burning. And so that's just what you were pointing out, is that the stick, when I pull it out, it might get melty, but it's not lighting on fire, and that's why. It's because it has to actually vaporize to catch on fire.
While we're waiting for that to cool and not be on fire.
Yeah, it's still on fire.
Yep. What should we do?
I think it's time to scale it up a little bit. We've done single crayons. I want to see a lot of crayons and more aluminum. Okay, we've got a bowl full of crayons and a crucible full of molten metal. Let's combine them.
I do not want to be standing there. Nothing. That took nothing. It is actually staying on top.
I am amazed that that has not just fallen right through. The fact that there's aluminum on top of the crayons
is
baffling.
Can you hear that? It's boiling.
Oh, yeah. I'll fill this cup with crayons with the papers on.
Does catch fire, it seems that our crayons with the paper are definitely staying lit a lot longer. Wow, that's an impressive amount of flame, and it is putting off a lot of heat. You can still see the aluminum. It didn't melt all of the crayons all the way through, and that is amazing.
Yeah, the fact that there's aluminum draped across crayons, I never would have thought that they would hold molten aluminum. I thought it would just cut right through them all.
Yeah, not in any way, shape, or form. That's awesome.
That's how I take it. Really hot.
Yeah! That is cool.
Ooh, that was neat.
That is pretty. Wait, what is that? Is
that's the aluminum?
Awesome!
That's a crayon wax right there.
Cling!
That is a funny shape right there. Look at that. That is well coated with wax. There it is. That is a chunk of aluminum poured into a pile of crayons, a bowl of crayons.
Crayons!
And then it's become coated in crayon wax as well. It's just covering it all. So we'd have to try and burn all that off to see the aluminum underneath, I think.
It's actually really, really pretty.
And warm.
Oh, it really is. Also, it smells terrible.
It does.
None of the others ever smelled this bad. What are they called?
Crayons. They have been, and they always shall be, crayons.
No kindergartner says crayon.
I say February.
He's the weird one.
So right here, where we've got this cool little fire twirl, this does kind of look like the aluminum and the crayons have, like, blended together.
Yeah,
maybe it's just
that's
a
so
puddle
pretty.
Of wax on top of aluminum, but, like, right at the edges, it almost looks like we have wax mixing with the metal. Pouring metal onto crayons looks super cool. Guys, you know we've always got more for you to see. That box at the top is gonna take you directly to our last video. You should go check that out. The other box shows you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. And if you hit this bomb in the middle, you get subscribed to the channel so you don't miss any of our cool videos. Don't forget to ring the bell, and we will see you in the next one. Talk to you then.